There's a strong atmosphere of God's glory here. Please just stay sensitive. I'm seeing the Lord ordain intercessors. I'm seeing the Lord is ordaining intercessors. The energy will go round. The energy will go round. The energy will go round. Touch, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name. Please be seated. I'll just give us a brief charge and then we will pray. Because when you want people, please help my sister. When you want to help people build capacity in the place of prayer, the best way to do it is to get them to pray. You learn to pray by praying. You become stronger in prayers by praying more. And you make progress in prayers by praying much more. So it's in praying that you make progress by prayer. And so this morning into the afternoon, we will spend some time to pray very brutally here. Very, very brutal prayers. I came with my friend and brother who is an intercessor. Because it's a prayer meeting, I wanted us to wield some scepters. So we'll not just talk about prayer, we will pray. And when we pray, the energy will envelop someone. And you will live here praying until you will become prayer. Someone that sings is a singer. Someone that dances is a dancer. The person who prays is a prayer. So you will live here and become prayer. And when you become prayer, the last thing you are concerned about are your needs. Because when a man prays, he becomes a router. You have more than enough to think of your needs. I assure you, in the name of Jesus Christ. I just want to share a few thoughts with us this morning before we proceed to praying. Mama said I should give us a charge on the subject, building capacity in prayers. And while I was meditating, it just dawned on me, if an army of praying women rises, Jesus may come next week. Because the efficacy and the productivity that the world will see will be in a geometric fashion. And so I trusted God to give me a few words that will quicken your inner man. So you will not just come for fellowship as usual. You will live here and you will go with the atmosphere of the fellowship. And your home will become a portal where the Holy Spirit, the Lord himself and his angels will continually traffic. And that will be somebody's portion in the name of Jesus. In the realm of God, there is a ranking system. Because the realm of God is a kingdom. And so when you come into a kingdom, men are profiled and ranked on the strength of the authority they command, to the degree that they are relevant to the king and the extent to which they can advance his purpose. The realm of God is not just a family. If it were a family, you would have enjoyed privileges on the strength of your birth system. And so the one who comes first would naturally receive an inheritance because of the right of the firstborn. But because the realm of God is not just a family, there are other indices by which God ranks men. Because there is a purpose in view, there's an agenda in view, and there is a will that must be advanced. Because every king is interested in territory, and every king is in the business of dominion. I've shared many times, and I would highlight again before I go forward, that God is not just a father. God is also a king, and God is also a judge. The fatherhood of God predisposes him to be benevolent towards you. And that's why you don't need so much to receive from God. All you need to do to receive from God is just to believe and to declare. He said, if you will say to this mountain, be thou removed, and you do not doubt in your heart, you will have whatsoever you say. The reason is because the fatherhood of God places an obligation upon him to take care of your needs. That's why I said, as wicked as your earthly parents are, will you ask them for bread and they give you stone? Or will you ask them for fish and they give you a serpent? That means in that realm, the least thing God can do for you is to answer your prayers. But much more than answering your prayer, there is a cadre and a ranking system that you must ascend in so that you will gain relevance in that realm, because you are dealing in a kingdom. Because when a king begins to interact with his subjects, he doesn't interact with all of them at the same level. He interacts with them on the strength of the authority that they command and the extent to which they advance his purpose. It will be unfortunate for a man or a woman to walk through the face of the earth and only interface with God as a father, receiving things from him just to lavish on his own appetite. When that man or woman crosses the divide of time into the realm of eternity, he or she will discover that life was more than bread and wine. We are in a kingdom. If you study Leviticus chapter 27, God began to tell Moses to grade the children of Israel according to their value. And he said, rate them by the values of the shekels of the sanctuary. A child that is less than 5 years old, if he is a female, there is a value allotted. 6 shekels, 3 shekels of the sanctuary. If he's a male, the value is 5 shekels of the sanctuary. Someone above the age of 5, but below the age of 20, if he's a male, he is what? 50 shekels of the sanctuary. If it's a female, it's worth 30 shekels of the sanctuary. Somebody who is above the age of 60. Now, the reason that value is much is because those ones can go to war. Because the king wants to advance the frontiers of his kingdom. So he is needing functionaries that can stand in battle and bring his glory to the ends of the earth. When people are above 60, their value now declines again. Now, in the Old Testament, he was judging them male and female because God dealt with men in the flesh in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, there's no male or female because our spirits have come alive. So in the New Testament, there is a structure and a value system by which God rates men. It's the strength to which they can intermingle with the Holy Spirit and deploy the resources of grace in advancing his kingdom. And whether you are a male or a female is not a factor, because in this context, it is by grace that we make progress.
We believe you are blessed. Please kindly subscribe to Spirit Flame Media for more edifying content. Thank you.